Hi, and welcome to my channel, Glamorous by Maggie. Today I'm going to be doing a all drugstore makeup look. I'm going to be using a couple new products. If you are not new to my channel, welcome back. It is so good to see you. I know it has been a hot minute since I have been filming and uploading videos. So hello, so good to see you. Thank you for coming back and watching my videos. When I started this look, I had no idea where I was gonna be going with the eye look, but I really like this kinda purpley, orangey look that I came up with. I hope you enjoy it as well. I'm just going to jump right in and get started on the video because it is very chatty and it is quite a long video. So I hope you enjoy. Hello. Wow. It has been one hot minute since I have been on camera recording. This is kind of crazy. It's going to take me a minute to get used to. I got lost in the holidays. My daughter was home from school. And then, if you can't tell from my voice, I've been sick and I just kind of lost track and lost motivation to do YouTube videos. So I am trying my best to get back on the train, find some inspiration, find some motivation, and get back on to recording for you guys. So I do greatly apologize for the long absence, but here I am, and I hope you guys enjoy this video. I got the new CoverGirl Outlast Stay Illuminous Natural Glow Foundation. I'm going to be trying today. I have never tried it, so hopefully it matches me well. I am a pale princess now that winter has hit and I've been sick and not self-tanning. So here we go. I've got my L'Oreal Infallible Beauty Sponge. I do love this beauty sponge. It is my favorite. So I will be using that to apply it. Ooh, it might be a little light, but we'll see. This feels very thick. Oh shoot, and I didn't put a primer on, so I guess we will not be using a primer and see how it works. Is very full coverage foundation. I did apply kind of a lot, so could probably be a medium to full coverage. But today it's gonna be more full coverage for me. The color matches pretty good. Let's see, the color I got is 825 Buff Beige. And I did also get the concealer, that's what I wanted to try most. And I got light, and it was super dark, like crazy dark. So I'm gonna return it and I'm gonna try the fair, but I don't know because the light was really dark, and I'm pretty sure that's all that they had was just the fair, the light, and then it was like medium and deep and tan. I think they didn't have very many shades, but I really wanted to try it. So far this foundation looks really nice. It looks very skin like even though it puts a lot of coverage. I guess it's more of a medium coverage, I would say. It's not like a full. Maybe, I don't know, I guess you could probably make it a full coverage, but it's a medium coverage on my skin right now. I like the shade. It's not like tacky, I like that. So far, so good. Okay, now I'm going to be using the e.l.f., the pink shade, just to correct my dark circles. And then I got the new Wet n Wild Come Correct concealer I'm gonna try today for you guys. Okay, in this color, they only had Fair, and it was on sale for like $2.50, so I was like, oh, I don't know. But the Fair shade looked like it matched my MAC Pro Longwear concealer shade perfect. So I'm thinking this will work just fine. Super thick. Okay, here we go. It is really thick, holy moly. I guess it is a little light. Hopefully I can blend it out nice. Wow, it is like crazy. Look at that, holy moly. I used, shoot, I don't know, barely any, and there's plenty here. Wow. A little of this stuff goes a very long way. A very long way. Like, there's none even on my finger. Holy moly, I got a ton. Alright, now I'm gonna try to blend that out. Hopefully it'll blend out. Goodness. One, I used way too much. I did not realize so little would go such a long ways. And for two, this Fair is a little light for my skin. I'm just gonna take some setting powder and try setting it. Okay, so far this Wet n Wild Come Correct, it is very thick. A little goes a very long way. Fair is pretty fair, but I think that if I went to use so much, it would have looked better. And I don't mind it, but if you look really close, it looks patchy right here where my bag is. So not too crazy about that. But we're gonna roll with it and see how my makeup look turns out. Now for my contour, I'm gonna just be using the Wet n Wild contouring palette. And then for my highlight, I have a cool little trick. So I got the Morphe 35F palette. I won it on Instagram from, I think it's Covert Cosmetics. I'll have their little name right there. But I won this palette, which is beautiful, stunning, absolutely gorgeous. But, oh my gosh, look at that. But I have been using these top shades over here as highlighters. And I've really been liking them, so I figured I'd do that for you today. I'm And I think it's just a nice, beautiful glow. And I used the second color in right here. The second color in from the sticker on the back. And then for blush, I'm going to use my Tickled Pink e.l.f. Mineral Blush. Just a nice kind of peachy skin color. And then because my skin is crazy wicked dry, I am gonna set it with my MAC setting spray. And I just found out that, that little sheet from my eyeshadow palette. I just heard that Milani came out with a setting spray and it is very nice. So I am going to have to jump on and get that. And then also they came out with some new highlighters and I want to order those too. They look really nice. But for now, I'm sorry, I don't have a drugstore setting spray. I'm just going to be using my MAC one. I don't know how I ever lived without setting spray. Okay, now I'm going to just fill in my brows really quick before we start on the eyes, and I'm just using the Maybelline Define a Brow. I'm going to do this off camera. So to start on the eyes, now, I love that this palette has all of these mattes down below. If I'm in a rush, I will literally just go and take like every other color and just keep applying, like my base color, in the crease color, make the crease a little bit darker, and then pop a little just to deepen up that outer corner, smoke it out a little bit. Or I'll just like apply this one all over the lid, put a wing on, call it good. Like, this palette is so nice for that. So if you're curious and want to know just some quick little looks, I've been doing that a lot lately. It's very nice. But today I wanted to do a little something fun since there's all these amazingly beautiful, shimmery, awesomeness colors. So I think though, just to start, I am going just going to take this first shade and apply it all over just to start my eye look. So I'm just going to take a fluffy brush here, a Morphe M514 brush. And yes, technically this Morphe shadow palette is not drugstore, but I think it's so affordable. You get 31 shadows. You get 31 shadows for 20 bucks, I think. So I think it's amazing quality. I think that it's considered drugstore. If you don't think consider it drugstore and you're bummed that I just whipped out a palette that's not from the drugstore, I do apologize. I'm sure you could find some of these shadows in the CoverGirl True palettes or whatever they're called. They have some really nice shimmery palette shades that they've been making. Anyways, okay, I'm going to just put this all over my crease here. Kind of all over my lid. It's that very first shade. And then when we have that all over, I'm going to take the third color in. It's just, I don't know what you'd call it. Just a very light, kind of peachy brown color, this third one. And I'm just going to focus that in the crease. So don't apply it all over like we just did. Just focus that in the crease. Just to kind of start our color here. Or start our shadow look, I guess. Your transitioning color. And then of course kind of blend out that top. And honestly, I have no idea what look we're going for right now or what we're gonna be ending up with, but we're just gonna roll with it. Okay, it's the very middle shade and it's the least shimmery one, this kind of purpley one. I'm gonna take that just on this e.l.f. crease brush and I'm just gonna take ever so lightly amount and I'm just gonna buff that in the crease. Start right in the crease and then kind of do the same to the other side here. And I'm gonna go in with just a clean brush just to blend in that middle part. Okay, and now I'm gonna be taking this shimmer shade. I'm gonna apply that all over the lid, but I'm not gonna bring it quite all the way into the inner corner. I'm just applying that on a flat shader brush. These shadows are beautiful. I love Morphe shadows. The pigmentation is just beautiful. I am getting fallout though a little bit, so just FYI. Okay, and then I'm going to be taking the shade that we used for the highlight, that the second one in on the top, in the inner corner. Then while we have that, I'm going to apply that in my inner corner highlight there and for my brow bone. Okay, and then I'm going to take a more pointed kind of crease brush. I'm going to go back with that very first purple shade that we used, the not so glittery. And I'm going to kind of do more of a darker corner here. I am going to take that purple color, run it along my waterline, my lower lash line there. This concealer, this Wet n Wild concealer, is very creasy under my eyes. Now I'm going to take a E18 Morphe. I'm going to take that very first brown shade that we used on the very bottom and buff out my lash line. And then just taking the brush I used to apply my setting powder, just kind of help buff that. I was thinking I was going to apply a wing, but I don't think so. I am going to just apply some mascara and false lashes and see what we get. Go apply my lashes really quick and I'll be right back. Okay, so I'm back. I applied some, just the NYX liquid liner, just to my lash line. Applied my false lashes. I just used the Ardell 120 Demi Wispies. I was going to use these, Salon Perfect Be Natural 610 lashes. These ones. But these bands are so thick. They remind me of like the House of Lashes, those bands. They're so thick. And I see like Jaclyn Hill and everybody just popping those suckers on. But for some reason, if they're a thick band, I can't get them to stay on my lashes. I don't know what I'm doing wrong or why thick bands are so hard for me to apply. But those lashes are beautiful. But the band is too thick. I cannot get it to stay to adhere to my lash line. So anyway, so I used the Demi 120 or the Ardell Demi 120 lashes. I just used some Lash Sensational mascara just to you know, blend in my original lashes. I'm just gonna apply my Too Faced Naked Dolly lipstick, because I always forget to do lipstick, so I'm gonna be better at this. So just a nice nude lip. And then I'm just gonna apply some Bare Minerals Marvelous Moxie Buttercream in Perky Pony, just to give it a little shine. So here is the look. I think it turned out really nice. For the foundation, I like it. It looks very natural, very skin-like, I think. I'll zoom in so you can take a look. That was the CoverGirl Outlast Stay Illuminous, the new foundation. As far as the Wet n Wild, what was it called? Come Correct Concealer. Not a fan. It is really patchy under my eyes, but I don't know if that's because I used way too much and I didn't really know what I was doing. So I'm gonna have to play around with it. But as for right now, I'm not a fan. It's pretty patchy. I want to give a quick little shout out saying thank you so much, Covert Cosmetics, for picking me to win the Morphe 35F palette. Beautiful palette. I've never received or had any sort of Morphe shadow palette that I have not liked. I love Morphe shadows. They are so buttery creamy. They blend out beautiful. The pigment is amazing. I love it. So I really like this look. It looks turned out really nice. I am going to go do my hair so you can see how I look and I actually do my hair. And I'll be back to say goodbye to you. Okay, here is the final look with my hair all done. Like I said before, I really like the way this look turned out. I wish my under eye concealer looked a little better, just so my look looked, you know, all together. Or not all together, but flawless altogether, I should say. Here's my final look. I hope you guys enjoyed. It was a very long, chatty tutorial. I feel like it took me like 3 hours to film this, but that's okay. Please give this video a thumbs up, comment below on other videos you'd like to see, and we'll see you next time.